Some of you before, and I really appreciate you coming, sharing information. I've been asked to say something about Okello's trial. What I can say is that the Norwegian embassy in Addis Ababa continuously requests to be given access to provide consular assistance to him as a Norwegian citizen. Problem is that we haven't been given such access. We continue to raise it through our embassy and through our politicians, the fact that as a Norwegian citizen, he's entitled to assistance from his government. But the readmission agreement, the asylum cases, I have advised the organizer of the demonstration that the Minister of Foreign Affairs is not responsible for the readmission agreement. It is the Minister of Justice. So I think you need to address your concern to them.
Yeah. Thank you. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Well, thank you for coming and conveying another letter. I've met some of you before, and I really appreciate you coming, sharing information. I've been asked to say something about Okello's trial. What I can say is that the Norwegian embassy in Addis Ababa continuously requests to be given access to provide consular assistance to him as a Norwegian citizen. Problem is that we haven't been given such access. We continue to raise it through our embassy and through our politicians, the fact that as a Norwegian citizen, he's entitled to assistance from his government. About the readmission agreement, the asylum cases, I have advised the organizer of the demonstration that the Minister of Foreign Affairs is not responsible for the readmission agreement. It is the Minister of Justice. So I think you need to address your concern to them. But obviously the Minister of Foreign Affairs, through our embassy, continue to follow the situation for human rights in Ethiopia, and especially the situation in Oromia.
But what about, you just said that Okello is, he was almost denied to be. So who is you? He has no access to
that. We have no access to him.
Doesn't tell you that these are terrorist regime in the 21st century. They're even kidnapping a Norwegian citizen that Norway has been supporting for like 25 years for the same murder regimes. And even your citizen is denied to access for lawyers. It tells you that how can a human being would think of deporting innocent Ethiopians from here to the murder regime? You have supported definitely one ethnic domination in Ethiopia, whereas there are 81 other ethnic groups. The Tigray mercenaries, they're not even more than 5% of the population in Ethiopia. Right now, 25 years, they get everything. And what we don't understand is Norway started to support them. It's okay to change because that could lead to the democratization. But it never happened. And supporting them 25 years and deporting innocent Ethiopians, they are here. We are here because TPLF is leading the country. If not, I can tell you, most of them would not be here. Yeah. There is no doubt about that. Therefore, how can you tell us that even one Norwegian citizen is not allowed to get that kind of treatment? That, can you even imagine sending innocent Ethiopian to murder a regime in Ethiopia?
Continuously have to
We are Norwegians, for example. If there is a democracy, I don't want to just stay here in Norway. And these guys and all the Ethiopians, almost about 800 Ethiopians, are registered to be sent back to Ethiopia. That is completely unacceptable, and we are asking your office to consider our concern and follow the international rules and the regulations. Because Norway is a symbol of democratization in the world. That's not for Ethiopians. It's not happening in Ethiopia.
Here, because you know, as we see all of us here, all of us, as an exile politics activist in Norway, for several years, we all of us have well documented, we are vulnerable, social media, everything. We have some parties participating in everything. And the degree of vulnerability is so high in social media, and the government is in charge of that terrorist action according to this connection. Someone has, you know, that terrorized the terrorization, anti-terrorism law in Ethiopia, which is adapted to charge any activists. So, by what responsibility, all of us, we are political activists. So, how can this agreement can be held? This is a serious issue. It's a matter of life.
And what about Amnesty International?
We need to address the Minister of Justice on the agenda. I'll make sure that the Minister of Foreign Affairs gets the letter, and I'll make sure he responds in a letter to you.
I'm sorry.
Thank you for the letter. I'll make sure that the Minister of Foreign Affairs gets it. I'll make sure that he sends the letter back to you. And if you want to request a meeting inside to have a further discussion, I'll be happy to facilitate that. But again, the readmission agreement you need to address to the Ministry of Justice.
I'm